We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we are talking mid-handicap irons. Now, over the last 2 months, we've been hitting all of the new products on the market, and we now feel in a position where we can tell you about our top performing mid-handicap irons of 2022. But let's get started. Let's have a look at how we categorise mid-handicap irons. We categorise irons by looking at groups between 1 and 5. So we start off with a blade at 1 and then work all our way over to 5, which is a hybrid iron, and everything else fits really neatly in between. Just tell us a bit more, Neil.
Yeah, so you can see a muscle back slash blade would be category 1, Simon, and that's where you're going to get your elite golfer, your better ball striker. We've just got a handicap guide with all the categories, guys. I know it's just a guide. A lot of you might be a little bit better ball striker than your handicap suggests. But obviously, category 1 there, you'd be 4 and below. And then, like Simon says, we'd right the way through. So you'd have your mid-handicap at category 3 and 3.5, handicap guide 10 and above, right the way to the end, which would be category 5, your hybrid iron, your mega forgiveness, anything from beginner standard right the way down, really, anybody that's new to the game.
Okay, brilliant. And we are looking at the 3 and 3.5 group today, and we've got 14 different clubs involved. So let's move on and let's have a look at how they compare in terms of data. Okay, we're going to start off by just looking at the amount of drop-off that you see with each iron in ball speed and in carry distance. And we've got a new category this year, Neil, as well, shot area.
Yeah, we've got a lot of guys, Simon, obviously requesting like dispersion, so we thought we'd add a little bit of a shot area in there as well.
So just talk us through what sort of stands out about this.
So first thing I want to talk about is the Ping G425. Renowned for forgiveness, and the data on the specific day kind of backs that up, Simon. You can see here that it's actually first in the shot area drop off of 175
square yards. It's almost like it's a benchmark.
Yeah, like a benchmark iron. Yeah, and I think with the Ping, I feel like it's one of them irons where you got like a bit of both. You got the forgiveness there, but it's not too big a footprint. Mm-hmm. Fantastic iron, very stable, and yeah, the data kind of backs that up.
And we've seen that a number of times with using Ping products, so that they always tend to be pretty accurate, yeah. Really good at protecting ball speed and carry distance drop-off,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah. Secondly, Sam, moving on, I've got to mention the PXG there, the 0311 XP, obviously, mm-hmm, the Gen 4. You can see here, to be number one for ball speed drop-off, number one for carry distance drop-off, and then to be second in the shot area, that is a very, very stable iron there. Mm-hmm. And it's also long. You can see that it's second in carry distance. So in terms of a thumbs up from a category there, it ticks all the boxes.
Okay, and then there's one other down here as well. So the Ben-Hogan-Edge-EX.
Yeah, can't be overlooked, that, really, because, again, scored well for all three there, for the ball speed, the carry distance, and the shot area. But what you've got to remember as well is it's at a very good price point. Mm-hmm. So if you aren't thinking about this top end, which a lot of guys will be buying golf clubs on a budget, definitely worth looking at, because again, it was a great performing iron.
Okay, just round this off then by just telling us a little bit more about why we don't look at the dispersion, because
it can be misleading, can't it?
It can be, but some people will look at this, you know, and they will go and buy a golf club just based on the data we've created. Mm. We know that on a different day, the shot area would be very different.
Of course, strike pattern's key, isn't it? I mean, regardless of what goes on, if you don't strike it properly, then you're going to get inconsistent data. But yeah, remember, it's all given for what's happened on the day.
Okay, so that's the drop-off, so that's the shot area. Let's just move on and just have a look at how all 14 clubs compared in terms of loft, ball speed, launch angle, backspin, and carry distance. What sort of stands out to you here?
I think the first thing we've got to try and pick up on here, Sam, is the Cobra King Limited XR. So people would say straight away when they say, oh, that's a strong loft, 26.5 for a 7-iron. But if you actually look at the numbers of what it's done in terms of ball speed, let's look at like launch, backspin, peak height and descent angle, especially peak height and descent angle, that's holding most greens out there with those numbers. So just because it's a strong loft, don't think that it's not going to perform, because that clearly does there. And obviously, it's long as well, 190 carry out of a 7-iron. Yeah, I'll take that any day.
Of course. And just make sure, you know, if you are looking at the longest here, make sure that you have got enough speed to be able to launch it up there.
Great point, yeah. Definitely. I think it does. That's a very valid point. Remember, if you've not got enough speed, club head speed, you might not get the numbers that you're looking at for if you go with less loft. Loft can be your friend at times.
Okay, and I'd say as well, really, really important to look at the loft down the side, because we have got sort of irons down here which are performing extremely well, even though they're not the strongest of loft. So one that sticks out to me would be the sub 70, the 699. So really, really good looking iron, performs very well for the loft that it's got, and it comes in for a very, very reasonable price as well.
Yeah, like I said before, the big thing is guys might be buying golf clubs on a budget, like we discussed with the Hogan, sub 70 falls into that category. And it's also worth mentioning, Simon, as well, about the averages along the bottom there, so the guys can try and see where, if they've seen a product that they like on the market, they can look at a little bit of a benchmark and see what it's done in terms of data for me personally against the rest.
Okay, just to add in there as well, so the PXG, so the 0-11, that people sort of think about PXG as being very, very expensive golf equipment. That is £75 an iron at the moment, so that compared to some of the top performers, it's actually really, really good value
good,
as well.
Good price point, very.
Okay, there's loads of information there. We have got a huge amount of difference between the longest and the shortest, but we feel that we've been able to come up with our top performing irons, mid-handicap irons of 2022. Let's move on and have a look at them. Okay, best mid-handicap irons of 2022. We've picked out six models here, and why have we picked them, Neil?
Yeah, I feel like all six here couldn't really be overlooked, Simon. First of all, the Cobra King. Limited X, it's got to be obviously because it's long, it felt very powerful, and looks quite good.
And it's pretty not good. The most expensive
there
on the market either.
Took the words right out of my mouth. The PXG, again, just because of its data, could not be overlooked. It scored well for all four categories really, because it was quite long as well. Great looking iron, compact, felt very stable with a miss it.
Yeah, I've actually used a set of these. What I really, really like about them is that it's not a huge amount of offset. So if you compare that against some of the other irons in the category, it's not very offset.
Yeah.
You know, so
quite pleasing
if that's
on
like
the iron.
A look that you like, that's a really, really good feature.
Ping G425 again, very stable. Seems to be like the benchmark iron for this category, really. Ping seems to this year on year, don't they? They make these very stable, forgiving irons and produce good ball speed. Just good all-round iron, really.
I'd also say in there as well that the short irons are a little bit more compact than what they have been in the past, because Ping irons, especially the G range, they've been quite boxy, quite long.
Yeah,
you know, so
quite wide.
Probably
sold
the
as well.
Best G short irons they've made for a very, very long time.
So. Yeah. TaylorMade-Stealth, again, really, really nice looking iron. When you look at it, actually, I was expecting it to be a lot bigger. If we were to look at previous models, Sim 2, Max and Max OS, obviously big footprint, not as big a footprint on this. And I quite like this, Simon, that it can be dialed in to the golfer's requirements.
That.
So 2 degrees stronger or 2 degrees weaker. If you're somebody that struggles to get the golf ball in the air, get a little bit more loft on there, you can really get them dialed in. And again, another great performing iron.
Okay, and if you're a more moderate speed player, you most definitely be looking at going up in loft.
Oh, definitely, definitely. Don't think
that would maximise carry distance.
Yeah, whereas a lot of guys will get carried away there, Simon, and think, oh, I need less loft to hit it further, but you're not going to get the thing in the air, guys.
Okay, so you've got Callaway-Rogue-ST-Max.
Yeah, a little bit more of a bigger footprint for me, a bit more of a thin, thicker top line to look at. But again, felt really good, stable, noticeably that it launched quite quick. For somebody who's lacking a bit of speed, fantastic.
Just a really good club golfer iron.
Yeah, definitely. Especially, and I know I've not tested it, but I reckon in the long irons, there'll be plenty of forgiveness there as well.
Okay, and then the Srixon, so the ZX4, what an iron.
Yeah, beautiful.
Really, really good iron.
Obviously hollow bodied, forged face, great feeling, really good looking, compact. That gets the thumbs up from me. It's one of my favourites, actually, the ZX4. Big fan.
Okay, we can't close out then without just having a look at how this category compares to the other categories that we've tested. Just tell us a little bit about this, because you might have quite a lot of people out there that are looking at two different categories, maybe.
Yeah, and if you just pick up on a little bit of the data just from my numbers alone, Simon, you can see that I'm 7 yards up in category 3 to 3.5. Compared against 2.5. So I'm giving up 7 yards. I'd like to consider myself an half-decent ball striker. So if you were a little bit more towards the side where you struggled with your ball striking, you were to ignore the three and a half cut and looking at two and a half, you'd sacrifice so much, in my opinion.
And that's a huge amount to put on the line just for a better looking iron.
Yeah, definitely. You've got to, if you can get something that looks good and it performs great, great, best of both of us, but please be open-minded, try these irons and get them dialed in to suit your game.
Brilliant. Okay, last point, if you're an average swing speed player or less than that, you should be looking more towards that end, getting more loft.
Yeah, definitely, hybrid type irons, your super game improvement irons, if you can get them a little bit where there's more loft there, guys, sometimes they can get the CG a little bit lower and further back, get it launching higher for you. Make the game, it's a difficult game as it is, isn't it? We're all looking for improvements, but don't be ashamed to try these. Sometimes golfers have got to swallow the pride and think, oh, I really want blades, I really want these, but you're sacrificing so much in doing so.
Okay, that's our best mid-handicap irons of 2022. If you've liked the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.